Corvo, the Loyalist Conspiracy thanks you for your work. I don't know if I can. My own brothers. We never believed that you killed the Empress. It made much more sense that the Royal Spymaster, now the Lord Regent, was behind it, aided by some of his key allies. We spent a lot of money and exposed ourselves to great risk in getting you out of prison. But we did it because we believe that you're the one that can make the difference.
Oh, and Havelock's looking for you.
In their work. The city is not yet secure.
All right, my friend. Martin's devised our next move. There's a footnote in Campbell's journal that tells us the Lord Regent's mistress sat for a portrait with Sokolov, the painter and royal physician. He'll be able to give us her name. Sokolov lives on Caldwin's Bridge about half the time, out over the river. The catch is that I'm afraid you've got to head out right away while Sokolov is at his apartment on the bridge. Samuel can get you close to the bridge, but you'll have to find Sokolov. Bring him back here intact, and it'll enable us to make our next move. I can't believe what you've done so far. Escaping from Coldridge, taking down the High Overseer, recovering Emily. You make this old military man proud. That's it, then.
Attention. Please report lights or strange noises emanating from evacuated districts.
Ask me for any gear you need.
You don't have much time, but don't forget to upgrade your gear with Piero.
Off to Caldwin's Bridge, sir. We'll get our sleep later. Just climb aboard when you're ready.
Caldwin's Bridge. You've been in the city for years, but you lived in Dunwall Tower with the late Empress, so maybe you haven't visited the bridge before tonight. Something to look out for. See all them lights on the water? That's right. We'll be spotted for sure. You're gonna have to shut off their power before I can pick you up. Now, about bringing Sokolov back alive. He's smart. Maybe even smarter than Piero. Got the whole of Dunwall under his thumb with all that natural philosophy business. New technology, potions and the like. Seems dangerous to me. But what do I know? Here we are. I'll meet you at the arches under Sokolov's place when you're ready, Corvo. Assuming, of course, you've taken care of those floodlights.
Nobody allowed to be just wandering about.
Yeah, it dies.
Yeah, I know. citizens and visitors to our city. By order of the region, the curfew is now active. No foot traffic is allowed across Caldwin's Bridge until curfew is lifted. Attention all citizens, no pedestrian movement is allowed along Caldwin's Bridge during this period. Curfew will end tomorrow morning at sunrise.
Tired yet? Please, not now.
Citizens and visitors to our city, by order of the region, the curfew is now active. No foot traffic is allowed across Caldwin's Bridge until curfew is lifted. Attention all.
curfew. How is anyone?
Well now, Mr. Pratchett. Even a wealthy man like you needs the city watch. Gangs are cutting throats and smashing windows left and right, and the weepers, excuse me, the plague victims are worse. Are you saying the Lord Regent is wrong for imposing curfew?
It won't do you any good to bait, sir.
But don't worry, I'll be fine. I'll be fine. A smart man can come out ahead,
even in a time of plague.
Sure, like that Sokolov. He's doing fine. Always a lot of exotic items coming and going from his place. Keeps this place running, at least for now.
Yes, yes, if by exotic you mean foul smelling as a witch's bottom. The royal physician will be fine too until he crosses the wrong man.
Their eyes against my tongue like the eggs of fish. I will set fire to the hairs of their faces.
Well, that was a lousy waste of effort.
Alex gone and so are the pearls. I hope he was smart enough to stash them someplace before he got caught.
You're the one told them to scout around.
That's right. Scouting is when you find out what the guards are doing and come back.
Well, now.
Might be scared of anything.
Hey, you there! Show yourself! City Watch, wake up! We've got some low-life breaking curfew. Let's show them who owns a bridge.
Go down, you pig!
Feed him to the hound.
What's going on?
Guards, to me!
lights are working perfect.
Well, there's nothing to do. And I like climbing the pillars. Just leave the oil tanks be, or they'll break. Why they always gotta put me with you, I just don't know.
Heard something. What was that?
I'll get to the bottom of this.
What was that?
Hey, what was that?
I know I heard
something. No, something's up.
What was that?
Check everywhere.
Keep skulking around.
Your own squad after what happened last night? Chances are very good.
Thank you.
absolutely sure he continues his work. The screams are evidence his work continues. Thus, the screams are evidence that he's done his job. The screams are evidence we have done our job. You know, Guardsman.
I don't care for you very much.
I have to keep this position. He says to bring a bottle,
I bring a bottle.
He says to bring food, I bring food. He says to undress, I undress.
Well, without Sokolov and his strange things, you'd probably be dead by now. Should we gather for whiskey and cigars tonight? Never doubt. I find you, it's going to be bad.
I know you're here.
Your heart dies.
I'll turn my hopes and energies to Formula 25, which in conjunction... which came to me most vividly in a dream last night, has great potential, according to the latest celestial... As for Test Subject 312, after the characteristic sloughing of the skin, she should be dead by mid-morning tomorrow.
Please let me go.
Thank you, whoever you are. He kept me in a cage, like an animal. The pain is horrible right now, so I'll just hide in a corner and leave when I'm feeling better.
Position himself.
You made a neat job of it. Drop him here and we'll be off. Set up the cell for Sokolov in the old kennel. Shackles and everything. It'll be a shock, him waking up in the straw and old dog poop. But from what I hear, he's woken up worse places. Guess we all have at that.
Well done, Cornwall. Well done. I doubt a dozen soldiers could have done it better. Sokolov's knowledge will enable us to strike at the Lord Regent directly, and ultimately help you get your life back. Soon, we won't have to hide in the shadows. The royal physician is brilliant, but he was a fool to protect the Lord Regent. Sokolov gave us the elixir, the war machine. He could have made us a great nation. Now he pays the price for siding with a tyrant. You have my thanks, sir. If you wish to get some sleep, now is a good time.
Corvo, wake up! You were making funny faces while you were sleeping. I decided to nap here in your room while Callista was taking her bath. She told me if there's ever trouble, I should always run here. Callista will come get me when she's done with her bath. Thanks, Corvo. It makes me feel better.
Attention, Dunwall citizens. The Ascendancy Circle has chosen. High Overseer. Let us all praise their choice. The dance of investiture will take place without delay.
I know it looks... I was inventing a new kind of lock. The tumblers, shaped like snowflakes. Okay. The truth is, there is no snowflake lock. I was just, you know, looking through the lock. I couldn't bear it if she knew. I know you're a man of honor, and I also know that you can kill me at any time. And for both of these reasons, I apologize and beg for your discretion.
City. Attention, Dunwall citizens. You are required to boil any water from public fountains or the river. Anyone who has consumed untreated water must be reported.
Royal Physician, I believe you and Corvo knew each other in former days. Unlike you, our friend Corvo knows what loyalty means.
Bah! I am loyal to my inner spirit. You are the one consorting with the most wanted man in the Empire.
It's my belief that Corvo was innocent in the death of the Empress, and the former Spymaster, or the Lord Regent, as he calls himself, is a ruthless tyrant bent on destroying this city, the heart of the Empire.
You are mistaken if you think there's love between me and our Lord Regent. But whatever you intend to do here, I assure you, I am beyond petty scare tactics.
If I don't scare you, Sokolov, perhaps these rats will, even if they don't carry plague. I've heard of a swarm of rats stripping a child's body to the bone in half a minute. I've heard worse. How long do you think it'll be before you talk? Before you beg to talk?
Rats? Is that the company you keep now, Admiral?
It's the company you keep that interests us, Sokolov. We know you painted a portrait of the Lord Regent's mistress, the very aristocrat who is funding the military with her fortune. She is the key to the Lord Regent's control over the city, and we must have her name.
Sorry, Admiral. I cannot help you. You're part of this rabble, but I know you have your reasons.
Yes, he does. All we need is the name of the Lord Regent's mistress. It's very simple.
I elect not to tell you. You will have to force the words from me, and I warn you, my willpower is quite legendary.
Curious strategy.
Of which I approve.
It's well known that Sokolov is virtually addicted to a rare liquor called King Street Brandy. The taste is revolting, but I happen to have a bottle. However, I am reluctant to give it to you for Sokolov. It cost me quite a lot. It is very expensive stuff, a blend of rare Pendician spices and a drop of whale oil. Would you care to purchase it?
I could use a drink. King Street Brandy? I didn't know any more existed. It is an extraordinary gift. I see I'm dealing with men of taste. I can tell you this much. She was always referred to as Lady Boyle. I painted her to be sure, but I never saw her face or learned her first name. You see, I painted her from behind. I assure you, she still makes a striking portrait. But I do not know which Boyle she is. I was to be introduced to her at a masked ball in her honor this very night. But I will miss that party, it seems.
A masked ball at the Boyle estate? Tonight? The timing is perfect, Corvo. But the Boyles are wealthy and ruthless, so security will be very tight.
Of course, you already have a mask, don't you, Corvo?
He's right. You will be able to mingle with them once you're on the ground. You'll have to find out which of the Boyle women is connected to the Lord Regent and take her out in whatever way you can devise. We're very close now. If you do this tonight, we'll be able to strike at the Lord Regent himself and put Emily on the throne. May the wind favor you.
I hear you're off to the Boyle's little bash tonight. I have just a tiny favor I'd like to ask you. Could you give this note to Lord Shaw? You'll know him. A rather brusque man wearing a wolf's mask. In fact, he may be looking for me.
Attention Dunwall citizens, anyone with information leading to the location and return of the Royal Physician is required to speak to the City Watch at once. Attention Dunwall citizens, due to the rise in the population of plague rats, you are warned to stay out of uninhabited buildings.
Consider seeing Piero before we set sail to the Grand Ball. The Boyle Costume Ball, huh? Well, that'll be fun, but not for everybody. You ready?
the stops for the Boyle family. I didn't think there'd be tall boys patrolling here tonight. Watch yourself, Corvo. They don't fool around. The good news is, once you get to the party, that mask of yours lets you blend right in. Enjoy your evening out with the folks of all of them. Better you than me.
Comes back, I'll earn another promotion.
Pendleton? What's he got to say to me?
Pendleton is a gutless, lying sack of shit. I hope he's paying you well for this.
damn cold tonight. Hurry up, and let's see what you're made of.
Lord Pendleton's representative will select his weapon. A contest of honor will take place between this anonymous gentleman acting for the challenger, Lord Trevor Pendleton, and Lord Shaw, the challenged party. You will each turn and proceed to the marked positions and remain facing away from each other as I count down from three. You may then turn and fire.
Get on with it. I'll kill this fool and we can all go back inside.
Sorry, my lord. We shall proceed. Stop. Stand right there. Three, two, one.
And that's another patron dead. What do we do now?
It's lucky we're in demand. I hear the Estermonts pay top coin. No use trying them tonight. Let's see if we can find a little brandy. Let the Boyles clean up the mess.
Welcome to the
party's Boyles. Indoors this time.
Hello. The Boyles hope you have a wonderful time tonight.
Careful. We tried for a peek upstairs, and the man on duty is an ass.
I should have taught him some manners. This party is a sham.
I'm sure he's just doing his job. A party like this, anyone might have crept in.
Excuse me, my cousin is a Marquis.
Of course I don't mean you, but people are desperate, and the Boyles are awfully wealthy these days.
Nonsense. Waverly just hires officers from the Watch to impress people.
Your obsession with the Boyle women. Will it never end?
You? A gentleman?
I'll have you know I'm as gentle as I need to be in any given situation. As I think I've proven.
I told you not to bring that up.
There's a great deal I could offer you.
Don't be silly. The rumors say the Boyles practically own your estate.
What if I said I could get you out of the city, away from all this? To Sir Kornos or further.
I don't believe you, but if you're telling the truth, we should talk further, but not here.
Excuse me.
Oh, leave him be.
Bless you.
Things are bad.
What most people don't remember is
yes, of course.
A half a year before the Empress died.
Excuse me. I say nothing against the Lord Regent. He's the only one holding this together. Excuse me.
Welcome to my party. I don't believe I've had the pleasure. What a deliciously sinful mask.
Evening, sir.
I trust you are. On the guest list, sir. Sickening rat. Did you hear about Mrs. Brimsley? You'll never believe this.
What is it now?
She had her job open.
Welcome to the Boyle estate.
I know your mission tonight. We must speak privately. I'm a friend of Pendleton's, and I've done a few favors for your cause. I know your purpose here tonight, and how to say this, your target is the woman I love. I swear that if you'll bring her to me unharmed, you will never hear of her again. There's a cellar directly below the kitchen. I'll wait for you there. I'm not proud of this, but surely it's better than seeing her killed. Her name is Esma. I won't harm her, I swear. I'm a man of means. Just bring her to the cellar, and I will keep her safe with me. Forever.
You should see this as an opportunity.
To what? Learn a trade? Join the city watch?
Go ahead, take it. Everyone does. I had a servant sew me an extra pocket.
Indeed.
Really? I know it's a party, but I hoped for some privacy here. Hello again.
Is it true that we've found all the whales have been taken from the apostates since the plague started?
Excuse me.
I trust you're behaving yourself.
Cunning costumes. But there must be a way to guess. They say Lydia's the sloppy one, and Waverly's a prude. Or is it the other way around? If only I could peek upstairs for
I need that prize.
Scary mask.
If I could get upstairs, one of them must have left traces.
Good evening.
That's quite a mask.
Doing all right.
Are you
there
on the guest list?
Are you trying to guess which one is which? I was thinking of sneaking upstairs to look for clues. Or would that be cheating?
No guests past this point.
Hello, sir.
Think you'll get your own squad after what happened last night?
Never doubt it. Okay, move it along.
Ooh,
enjoying yourself? Doing all right there?
I really should have received an invitation to the Boyle estate. Thank you.
Now, do you know what my sisters are wearing? Silly, she's wearing red tonight. Oh my word, I wasn't supposed to say, was I? Lydia and Waverly will be so furious. This is exactly what they said would happen. Oh, don't stop now. This is so thrilling. Come with me.
Please move along.
Yourself. I take everything I can carry. They'll never miss it.
Will our sisters in the Oracular Order make a pronoun?
You know, I have a dirty little secret. You can't imagine who I'm seeing. I mean, if people...
Where is she? Hurry and bring her to me.
You found her! Quickly, let's get her on board.
At last, oh my love. Someday you will understand. You'll never know how happy you've made me. Someday she'll learn to appreciate me. After all, she'll have her whole life.
Granny Rags used to live right here?
Who? That crazy old lady?
They say she used to be a noblewoman until her whole family died off. They say she sold them to the outsider.
How about this? You do your thing, and I'll watch out for scary old ladies.
You enjoyed your evening, sir. But we'd best be on our way. Quickly. Pendleton said he would meet us here. I checked the wine cellar. Losing family gives a man a thirst.
I trust you enjoyed the Boyle's hospitality.
The masked criminal is believed to be hiding in a quarantine district. All citizens must report unexplained lights, odd sounds, and signs of conflict originating from
You did it. And now we've done away with a woman and a noble woman at that. But Boyle was a viper. She helped the Lord Regent kill the Empress. So I don't feel a thing for her.
Personally? I heard you upheld my name in a rather spectacular style and at some risk to yourself. I want to thank you for it. This little item has been helpful to my family over the generations, but I think you'll find more use for it than I ever will. Go on, take it.
You've had a long night, Corvo, but I fear it's not over. Havelock and Martin have already cooked up something more for you. They would like to see you now, in Havelock's chambers above the bar.
Attention, Dunwall citizens. The streets adjacent to Boyle Manor remain off limits pending an ongoing investigation.
Corvo, the time has come. Everything we have done, everything that you have done, has served to make this moment possible.
The Lord Regent is exposed, Corvo. Vulnerable. And now everything is in place to strike at him. We're one step from the throne.
One man. One beating heart is all that's left of the forces that brought this city to the brink of ruin.
It is simple, but it will be far from easy. The Lord Regent's paranoia has reached an all-time high. He has lost the support of the overseers, the parliament, his financial base, and he's lost Sokolov, who made his security technology. So at Dunwall Tower, he has consolidated every remaining loyal man around him.
He knows something is coming. He knows you are coming, and everything depends on him being correct. Piero will help you prepare, then Samuel will take you close to the tower, near the waterlock. Last time you were there was the horrible day that all of this started. Now you will go there and end it. Good luck, Corvo.
I'm not sure what else we could say, other than our hopes are riding on you.
Hello, love. I once snuck into a party at the Brimsleys. Very strange it was, too.
Do you need me to build something for you? I can make anything, practically.
Face the Lord Regent? About time we took care of Mysay. Long past time. This is it, Corvo. Last memories of Dunwall Tower might not be good ones, huh? So maybe you could make up for what happened back then. It'll be a bit of a climb from the water lot. Most important thing is killing the Lord Regent. Built himself quite a place at the top of the tower. Calls it his safe room or something. Crazy if you ask me. Another point of interest while I'm giving you the grand tour, Corvo. Broadcast control station here, where all them announcements come from, might be worth looking into. You ready? Next time I see you, the Lord Regent will be dead. And if not, well, it was an honor to serve with you.
Dark for whistling on duty.
How's he gonna hear this assassin coming? And Ferris, Doc for not bathing enough? He says the assassin's going to smell him in the dark.
I have a mind to dock you for too much conversing, guardsman.
Oh, no you won't. Because I helped with the new alarm for Lord Regent Asper. And he says to me, good work. That's right, me. For a second, I thought he might...
What now?
Aldo got docked for whistling on duty. Regent asks, how's he gonna hear this assassin come? Ferris?
Docked for not bathing enough?
He says the assassin's gonna smell the gun.
I have a mind to dock you for too much conversing, guardsman.
And he says to me, good work. That's right, me. For a second, I thought he might even shake hands, but then... Aldo got docked for whistling on duty. Regent asks, how's he gonna hear this assassin come? And Ferris, docked for not... He says the assassin's going to smell him in the dark.
I have a mind to...
With the boy's staff, keep your eyes open.
Assignments report directly to the duty officer.
Think you'll get your own squad after what happened last night?
Indeed, I believe so.
tower personnel. Remain on post until you receive further orders.
Again, I'm going to head down and retire to my bedroom.
Begging your pardon, sir, but I think it would be best if you stay in your safe room on the roof.
I need the comfort of my own bed tonight. I trust you and your men can handle the tower security. Double the guard if you have to. Come see me before you finish your rounds.
Yes, as you wish, Lord Regent. I'm heading up. Keep this area secure and use that alarm if there's any sign of trouble.
Yes, sir.
It's just ridiculous.
citywide ban on whale oil is now in effect. Citizens are encouraged to bring any whale oil in their possession to the city watch at once. Anyone caught burning oil will be subject to arrest. Please, please don't hurt me. You're here to kill the Regent, aren't you? Spare my life, and I can help you beat him. He makes recordings on audiograph, secrets, some that would destroy him if others heard. Played on this amplifier, his confessions would be broadcast throughout the city. He'll be ruined. The audiograph card you want is in a safe in the Lord Regent's room, but I was able to see the combination over his shoulder. 935. Trust me, what's recorded on that card will do the trick. Good luck.
should we gather for whiskey and cigars tonight? Indeed, I believe so.
Is it all done? You ready to go back to the Hound Pits? Thanks to you, Corvo. All right, let's go. Big changes. Makes me uneasy, to tell the truth. A small fry like me always gets the worst of it. But maybe it's going to be different now. The Lord Regent is gone. The Abbey has a new High Overseer. I'm guessing our work is almost done. The others are in the bar. No doubt waiting to raise a glass in your name. Me, I think I'll just linger out here if you don't mind. Reflect on things while we have a moment. Congratulations, Corvo.